Hello and welcome to Signal Processing Toolbox video. In this video, we are going to illustrate the features of Signal Processing Toolbox using the example of a boost converter with a simple voltage regulation loop. We will do it in several steps. First, we will draw the boost converter circuit using the elements available in the Typhoon HIL schematic editor's model library. Then, we will add a resistor with a switch to the output to allow us to change the boost converter load during runtime. Then, we will model the simple voltage regulator using the signal processing toolbox. Finally, we will investigate the performance of the resulting model. It may be interesting to point out that the voltage regulator will run with a 50 microsecond time step and provide a reference to the PWM modulator carrier running at 10 kHz. The resolution of the PWM signal is 6.7 nanoseconds, and so is the PWM resolution of the boost converter switch. Finally, the boost converter circuit will be emulated in real time with 1 microsecond time step. Please note that the main goal of this video is to illustrate the features of the signal processing toolbox. Let us now model the voltage regulator. We start with the adder, that is, with the sum component located in the signal processing library under math operations. Let's drag and drop it and double click it to adjust its properties. It is important to mention that running behind the signal processing blocks is Python code, so you can use the Python syntax and logic here. We typed plus minus because we want to get a difference between two signals. Boost output voltage being the first signal and our reference, the second of the two signals. The setting for execution can be left as inherit. Inherit means that the block takes the same execution rate as the element before. Please bear in mind that this numerical layer that we are using to design the control is running with a different time step than the power stage simulation. Now, we would like to be able to define and modify the reference later during the simulation from the HIL control panel. For this type of user inputs, we will use the control panel input. Let's change its default name to reference. And let's now open its settings. For group, we will use boost. As the label, we can use reference. The minimum can be 0, while the maximum can be 100. We will leave the signal type, default value, and unit as they are. We will only change the execution ratio to TS. We enter TS as a variable for the execution rate. Its value can be defined from model initialization function where we can easily modify global variables. This allows us to update the execution rate for multiple blocks at once. To have our controller read the boost output voltage, we must enable this functionality for the voltage meter Vout. We can do it very easily. We double click it, go to the signal processing tab, and then in the signal output we choose true. For the execution rate we will use TS, which means that it can be updated as a global variable. At this point we want to build a simple PI controller. The easiest way to do that would be by using the pre-built PID controller element and choosing PI as the controller type. For demo purposes, however, we will assemble the PI controller using simpler blocks. Let us drag two gains for the proportional and the integral part, and let's set their gain parameters. Based on the circuit parameters, we will set the gains to P 0.6 times 0.01, and we will set I to 1. We also need an integrator. And please note that it comes with external reset possibilities. We also need another sum function and a limiter to complete the PI controller. We are almost finished. We now need to connect our modulation signal with a boost which has an integrated carrier-based PWM modulator. To activate the modulator, we double-click on the boost. Choose internal modulator as a control and set the parameters. We will only change the dead time period to 1E-6, which is actually 1 microsecond. The last thing we need to add is another user input to enable the PWM modulator. We will copy the reference CP and change the label to PWM enable and set max to 1. To further simplify the model, we will build a subsystem from parts of the model. In this demo, we make a subsystem from the signal processing block in a few simple steps. First, we select the block. Right-click on a selected component or on the background, and we then choose Create Subsystem from Selection. Then we arrange inputs and outputs of the subsystem. Let's rename OUT1 to Enable by double-clicking on its label and choosing Top Side with a double-click on the icon. Now let's change OUT2 into Modulation Signal and let's choose Top Signal. We can leave the input name as it is and just change the input side to right. Please note that the compilation is completed in less than 60 seconds. Let us now parameterize the emulation. Let us set the input voltage to 35 volts. Now, let us define the input of the switch that we will use to control the output load of the converter. Let us put 1 in the settings to enable the PWM output, and as a reference for the output voltage, we can start with, let's say, 40. Finally, we need to map the signals that we want to observe on our scope. We would like to take a look at input and output voltages so we can put those on AO1 and AO2 respectively. We would also like to observe the inductor current so we can direct this signal to, say, AO3. Now we can run the simulation, open our scope and set the number of viewports to 4. And select the signals that we want to observe. V in, V out, IL, and boost 1 PWM modulator top 1. We can undock the scope and start changing the load profile, reference for the desired output, etc., etc., etc. We hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos.